Hi, in today's video we're going to talk about how Linda learned to walk again. Just to give you insights that might benefit your process of going to walk more normal or normal again. Before I give Linda the word, just describe the background that Linda was at when she really decided to get rid of her ankle brace and to start to walk more normal again.
This is the Brain Rehab Channel, where we show stroke survivors and those with a brain injury how to continue to improve. We are out-of-the-box thinkers and bending the rules of rehab. Linda, stroke survivor, biohacker, and best-selling author of Stroke Rebels. Arjun, functional neurologist and expert brain trainer. We are Brain.Rehab.
As you probably know by now, Linda suffered a severe stroke on the right in the right hemisphere. That was her dominant hemisphere, that's where her language resides, and her left-handed and left-sidedness was severely affected by that. Doctors doubted if she would ever walk or talk again, and that is apart from if she would ever be able to use her left arm again. Linda, at 9 months after stroke, was in a wheelchair chair some of the time, especially when she had to go somewhere. For example, if you read Linda's book, when they went off to Hawaii after 9 months, she was in a wheelchair, but she refused to stay in the wheelchair. She wanted to walk to the gate, much to the frustration of her family. Linda walked with a cane. She had a brace on. Now, the brace is a common practice after stroke, especially when you have a drop foot or the foot is pointing downwards because of spasticity. While Linda was on holiday, she decided, because she had to hope that she would walk again, she knew that what must be possible, and she didn't believe that the brace was going to be there all the time or that it was necessary. So she made a bold move and she decided, in a very enriched environment, nice environment, lots of new impressions, first time she really had hope that things could change. So she got rid of the braid, she took it off, which I have to say is a very dangerous thing because of the weakness in the affected leg, so you really have to discuss this with professionals if you're going to do the same. But anyway, Linda did so, and it was not a pretty sight. She walked very ungainly. People were really afraid that she would be fallen. Her family was really upset because they thought it was dangerous. But in Linda's mind, this all made sense, not only to get rid of the brace, and I'm going to talk more about the background of what she did was actually a very good thing, more on that later. People really were afraid that she would fall because it looked really terrible, her walking, and it took her a couple of weeks to really master the first steps in a reasonable looking way, but that took months to master afterwards. Now, Linda imagined that she was like a caveman and she broke her foot and she had to survive anyway. So she had to get rid of the brace. And in order to survive, she had to get rid of her brace, get more mobile again and learn to walk. With that mindset, she started to walk barefoot. Linda had done a lot of research on barefoot walking and discovered there's a lot of benefits to barefoot walking, as I will explain in the part after Linda tells about her adventure getting rid of the brace and learning to walk again. So Linda set off. She started walking on grass, on sand, on rock, on tiles, on asphalt, in the house, on wood, with bare feet. Now, later I will explain that you have to build this up because your feet are very sensitive if they have been in a cast or in shoes before. So, a word of warning again. Anyway, so Linda proceeded with this. She got rid of her brace and it took a lot of weeks, if not months, to get into a reasonable, normal walking pattern again. And the barefoot walking is probably a very smart move of Linda in this whole process. So in the next part, where I'm going to explain some things around what Linda did, I'm going to explain the benefits of barefoot walking, or better said, that you already can get rid of your shoes when you're seated or in the house and you're in a safe environment, and it will greatly benefit how your brain can regain function. Now, enough said. Linda, the word is to you. You have something important to say to anyone that has problems walking and wants to relearn walking again, even if the doctor said that it is not possible. On to you, Linda. I have talked enough. It's better that they hear from you. Why did you get rid of your brace? Especially because I'm sure the doctors were not too happy about that.
Yeah, they told me that I would wear my brace for the rest of my life.
Mm. Yeah, and what could you do at 9 months? Because I don't think you were able to do much with your foot.
No, I couldn't extend my foot. I could only extend my large left toe.
And then not much either, probably, just a little bit. So then you finally went on your first holiday since your stroke, which was already exciting. Mm-hmm. You write about that in your book. And then what happened on the holiday?
I decided to throw away my brace and my stick, to the horror of my family.
I can imagine. It's a good thing I was not there. I would probably have told you not to do it.
Yeah.
So I'm happy that I didn't, because you had great results with it.
Yeah. Because I had read about neuroplasticity, and even though I could not extend my foot, I could extend my toe, and that was the
start.
Beginning. I figured if I would force myself to walk, my foot will extend itself through time.
Yeah, that was not a bad thought, because the toe already could do it, and then there must at least be some pathway left.
Yeah.
Then you force, and you read about barefoot walking.
Yeah.
That inspired you probably to do it.
Yes, it did. I have read about barefoot walking, that it gives so much more feedback to the brain.
Yeah, and it's one of the biggest sensory areas of your body, and basically most of us cage it in, so there's not much happening there.
Yeah.
And especially when you have trouble with your foot after a stroke or a brain injury, then it's even more important to pay attention to it. So you did two things. You forced yourself basically to get rid of it, and you decided, I can do it. So you believed in that it was possible. And you knew for sure that it would benefit the feedback from your foot to your brain.
So I walked in the mud, grass, on the stones, and in water.
Awesome.
Yeah, barefoot.
Yeah. How did it look?
It looked ridiculous.
Okay.
But I imagine myself as a caveman, who could only survive through walking.
Yeah, so basically it was a survival mechanism that you put into motion. And it did the trick, because after a couple of weeks you were...
A couple of months.
Yeah.
I could extend my foot more and more.
Wow, awesome. Yeah. And I'm going to explain in the rest of the video a little bit more why what Linda did, getting rid of the brace and getting rid of shoes, walking barefoot, is such a very powerful concept.
It's really powerful.
It's the key. Yeah. I think we believe at least it's the key to a big next step in learning to walk again and learning to walk proper. And I'm going to explain more about that now. Thank you.
Thank you.
So, why is barefoot walking or going barefoot, getting rid of your ankle brace, so vital for making a big next step in learning, relearning to walk again? Now I will take you back to when you were born and your first year of life. How often did you wear shoes? Well, I hope you didn't wear shoes very often. The foot sole is one of the richest areas of your whole body, together with your mouth, face, hand, in sensory information. So touch, proprioception, the information from your body to your brain, one of the richest areas is around your foot. What have we done, especially in the last half century, we have shot our foot or feet with shoes. And the shoes have become more and more polstered to dampen the impact from walking. Now, later I'm going to tell you that it is very important that you have direct contact with the ground, with the floor, and that it has a great benefit to your brain. So there's three areas that I'm going to talk about. First of all, the richness of sensory information from your feet to your brain and why we should make use of it. We're going to talk about balance in relation to barefoot walking. And we're going to talk about foot and leg and back mechanics in relation to learning to walk again and in relation to barefoot walking. Now, as I said, the feet have a lot of sensory endings in them. They are for feeling around. Just imagine that you are barefoot walking like our ancestors did not that long ago. Most people went on barely anything under their feet and had a lot of feeling with what they were walking on. And there's even tribes nowadays that go barefoot, and there's a lot of runners that run without shoes. More on that later, why that's so important. We have to get rid of not only the brace and shoes to make use of that rich environment of sensors. And we can do that by taking off our shoes and also our braces in a safe environment where there's not much pressure on your feet. Why is this so important? The feet constantly provide your brain with information about your environment. This does not take place when you brace your ankle. Then you create a static information, and a static position of a joint leads to no information to your brain. Your brain disregards the area. We know from studies that putting a foot or an arm in plaster leads to brain map changes in 1 or 2 weeks, and they are permanent. So if you go too long in a brace or too long in too tight or too strong shoes, this will lead to alteration of your foot map, which is huge in the brain, like your lips and like your hand. Then you deafferentate, you change your body map, foot map on the brain permanently. And that is exactly what you don't want when you're dealing with spasticity or have weakness in a leg after a stroke or a brain injury. You want to feed the brain with sensory information, and that's why going barefoot is the best thing. That was a very smart move of Linda to do that, because she suddenly fed her brain with loads of new information and loads of new textures and environment. That brings me to the next item, that is balance and mobility in the foot. I explained in other trainings and other videos that in order to regain maximum brain function, you need a couple of building blocks into place. You need the primitive movements that you're born with. You have to get rid of them by starting to use your body and repeating primitive movements, which build into more and more complex movements. You have to build a very strong core by lifting yourself up, by strengthening the muscles around your shoulders and hips. And on top of that, you need to integrate all the senses of your body with eyesight, with hearing, with the balance system. So the vestibular integration has to be intact. And on top of that, all the other senses like touch, like eyesight, like hearing, like smell, they are fed into the brain. So there's a specific order. When you brace the foot, or when the foot is not touched, and we know that after a stroke, the connection between the frontal parts and mid parts of the brain lead to that when the foot is touched, your toes flare and they go up, a so-called Babinski sign, which is a sign that there is damage in the tracks from your head to your foot. We start to need touching that foot to get rid of this primitive reflex, which is more of a startle withdrawal, a startle response from that reappears after damage to the brain. So it's very important to start taking off shoes, start to stimulate your foot again to make sure that you don't get this primitive reflex back, and which will greatly affect the way you walk and the way you can use your foot. That's number one. So that is in the basis to rebuilding your brain. Then the balance thing. The foot is there to balance on while walking. Balance is very important. I explained that in other trainings for stimulation of the brain. Balance, the constant force of gravity on your muscles, provides your brain with a constant source of information, which provides the basic brain activity that you need to rebuild your brain. So, getting rid of a brace, getting rid of shoes, forces you to balance more, to make use of all the joints in your foot. We know that if you're wearing shoes all the time, you're not barefoot walking, you have an ankle brace on, all the joints in your foot, they get fixed, they get immobilized. I see that with the patients in my clinic, almost everyone that's always wearing shoes, also runners especially, that greatly impact their feet in an abnormal way, more on that later, they get a lot of fixation. There's a lot of people with foot problems, and that leads us to wear more shoes with polstering and cushioning. So you have to think about that. Now, walking barefoot, and that can just be in place sitting on a chair, will loosen up your feet, will make it possible to adapt to small alterations in your balance much better than when you're just static. Yes, it is safer with a brace. Yes, it is easier with a shoe on. But on bare feet, like you were when you were born, we are there to have bare feet. We came up with the idea to wear shoes and we unhardened our feet. So we have to get rid of our shoes and the brace to improve the input from the balancing act, the proprioception, the sense of feeling where we are in space, where your foot is in space in relation to the rest of the body, and where and that will greatly enhance brain function, stimulate brain function. Then, when we get rid of the brace more often, we get movement back again in the feet and in the toes, which otherwise become very static and fixated. Actually, the patients that I see in my clinic always ask me to loosen their foot because it feels so good. Why does it feel so good? Because it feeds the brain. So, very good reason to get rid of the brace more and more often and get rid of shoes and start to walk barefoot. Barefoot walking, and then you can do all kinds of surfaces, will really stimulate, loosen your feet, but you have to build it up gradually. If you're not used to it, your foot is fixed, your skin is not very thick, you can develop sores. It can be a little dangerous because you can twist your ankles. You have to build this up in a safe environment where you can walk with a cane, where you can hold on to someone else to gradually build it up over the weeks and months. Linda did this drastically, hence the very quick results. Now, third item with barefoot walking is that it really improves mechanics. Now, this is really interesting. You're post-stroke. That means that your foot is most likely in a pointed down position because of spasticity in the leg or weakness of the toe and the foot extensors. This has a great effect on the way we walk. If we put shoes on and a brace, we impact our heel first on the floor before we start to toe off. So we impact our heel. This has big consequence for our knees, for the use of the muscles in our legs. We know that walking with shoes, running shoes, etc., will lead to more shin splints and overuse of the knees because of the high impact heel strike. With barefoot walking, runners that run barefoot or people that walk barefoot, they don't have this forceful heel strike, but they impact the foot more midway and in front of the foot. And this is a much lighter way to walk and to run. And because after your stroke or brain injury, your foot is already weaker, it will have the tendency to strike down with the toes and the midfoot first. So it makes sense to try the barefoot walking to get back into a more normal walking pattern because it's already in this position. Now, we know from studies, and there's a lot of studies on barefoot walking, that barefoot walking, so walking without shoes, also without a brace, not only has a huge impact on the feet to the brain and on the balance capacity and on the feedback from the foot, but it has a great impact on the health of your knees, of your hips, and the stability, the core stability of your lower back. I say that again, walking barefoot has been shown to be beneficial in the long term on the health of your leg, the muscles in your leg. You develop the muscles in your leg in a much better way. They are better proportioned. The muscles in the front and the back are more balanced. We have less force on the knee, less force on the hip, and we have less force on the lower back. So barefoot walking has a lot of benefits. And I urge you, and especially with the story of Linda in mind, to start getting rid of shoes some or most of the day when you don't need them. Of course, be careful with it. If you're going to walk on dangerous terrain, you need them. And you have to build this up, so you should consult your doctor or your professional to discuss how you're going to do this. When you're dealing with diabetes, you have to be especially careful, but there are shoes that are for barefoot walking, so you can protect them with as thin a layer between your foot and the earth. And I think you understand now why it is so important that you start doing this. See you in the next video. Until then.
Our brain.rehab portal is a continuous improvement training platform for the home situation. It contains the best training, masterclasses, latest news, and interviews on topics that will keep you improving in the years to come. Check out what it can do for you and become a member of the Brain.Rehab tribe. www.brain.rehab.